In this illustration, you can see another connection of a spherical capacitor. And here figure shows a spherical capacitor of which inner shell is supplied some charge by a battery and outer shell is not connected anywhere. And again, we are required to find the effective capacitance of the system. So here you can see if this C1, this C2 and the outer plate of C2 is connected, assumed to be connected to earth. So here we can see in the equivalent circuit of this situation, there are two capacitors, C1 and C2. The middle shell is not connected anywhere and outer shell is directly connected or assumed to be connected to earth. Because this shell is not connected anywhere. And on the inner plate of this capacitor C1, a battery is connected, which is of voltage V, and one side of which is R. Here you can see we can consider C1 and C2 to be in series combination connected across the battery. So here directly we can write the effective capacitance of the system will be given by C1 C2 over C1 plus C2. Or we can calculate it by series combination 1 by C effective, which is 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2. This one is seen. So here we can see the value of 1 by C effective can be written as the values of C1 and C2 we already know. C1 is 4 pi epsilon naught AB upon B minus A and C2 is 4 pi epsilon naught B. We substitute the values, thus B minus A by 4 pi epsilon naught AB plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught B. On simplifying, we are getting 1 by C effective is equals to, here we can take this 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught B as LCM common. So this will be B minus A by A plus 1. And this giving us on simplifying this B by A, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught A. So the value of C effective here we are getting is 4 pi epsilon naught A. That is the answer to this problem.